Thank you.
Yes, darling, I know.
Grace, what happened to your shoes, Possum?
Well, these are your shoes. You know, the shoes that I ordered for the party, they didn't come today. They were too small, so I tried to borrow yours, but yours are too big.
I'm sorry.
So I
just have to you look gorgeous, just as you are.
Oh, thank you.
Absolutely. Informality is the keynote here, isn't it, Tony?
I'm on my way to this great party, and I thought I'd go as Delilah, so I brought my scissors along. Anyone for a haircut?
Yeah. It could be handy snipping off Madge's bandages later. You brought this video. Is this your beautiful new hit single? I can't wait to see it. Can I snap it into my slot?
Oh, yes.
Can sing underwater, Grace.
Oh, I know.
Wearing sunglasses.
I know, and I put the bathing suit on when I'm in the bed. It was quite the opposite.
It was like solo synchro swimming in my jacuzzi, too.
Yes, it was
a
little bit
warm. And then you hopped into the satin sheets.
Oh, yes, it was wonderful with all those men, you know.
No wonder you're always wetting the bed, Grace.
It's a great...
Boys, they reminded me of friends of my son Kenny, as a matter of fact.
He's wonderful.
Yes, and he's a gorgeous boy. I think I saw Clifford Smale, his flatmate amongst those boys. Many years ago, Grace, you shared a flat with a little friend of mine, Jerry Hall, in Paris.
Yes.
They must have been exciting days.
Oh,
were they?
Wild.
Who did the washing up?
We didn't eat. We didn't eat at all.
Didn't you? But I mean,
no, we just drank champagne at night.
Oh, you didn't mark the eggs with a pencil mark, or
no, nothing.
Actually,
we started out in a very small hotel room, and we used to have to raid the kitchen when we came in at night from going out to the clubs and stuff.
Oh.
But it was good because we had to stay small anyway for modeling.
Were there a lot of phone calls?
Oh, yes, quite a lot.
For two outgoing girls, there are probably a lot of incoming calls, I would
say. We were moving too fast, though. We were never home. So there were a lot of messages, and we were like butterflies, really.
What a striking couple I must have been, Tony. You didn't ever strike each other, I hope, Grace.
No, only verbally.
Only
verbally. I mean,
that can sometimes hurt more than
we were always fighting over the same guy, actually.
You have a reputation for being rather a quick-tempered little lass, you know.
Oh, it depends on if I'm tired, really.
I don't agree with that.
You know when you're tired. Well, I think I was a bit young then. I mean, now I just count to 10 and then I hit. I think it's a good idea.
Well,
it makes me feel better afterwards, you know, because I had an ulcer when I was 15 years old.
That's very young. It suggests
very
a lot of
tension. Very young
and
very painful. It was worse than having my child. And I decided from that moment on I was never going to have another ulcer again. And when someone irritates me, I'm just going to let it out.
I think it's healthier.
It is healthier.
So long as
why
it doesn't happen
I
here.
Suffer? So long as
it wouldn't happen here, would it, Gracie?
No, but we're two girls like us. Friends.
We are.
We're flatmates for the moment.
We are. And I had little Dolph, you know, your ex staying here.
Yes, I gave him a couple of whammies.
You lamb. He stayed here. You're in his bed, as a matter of fact. Not for the first time, but I mean...
Too good. There goes your scissor.
You're out there, Grace. No, excuse me, Tony. I'm speaking to Grace.
Fixing my scissor there.
I was fixing
your
scissor.
Your outlet is music at the moment.
Well, yes.
It is your creative outlet.
It's wonderful.
They have a naked energy. There's a raw and naked energy. And you are known. In fact, you've wandered about this beautiful flat with no clothes on at all for the last couple of days.
Yes.
And you don't... It is a thing of yours, isn't it?
Doesn't...
Why should it if you're gorgeous?
I mean, I think as long as it looks good, you know,
exactly.
And feels good. It doesn't even have to look good. If it feels good, then it's going to look good.
You've even given interviews, though, Grace.
Yes.
In your birthday suit.
Yes, I did it recently, actually. I was in the bathtub and he arrived and I said, well, ask him, does he mind? I mean, I'm in the bath and would he mind doing it in the bathtub? And they didn't have any bubbles in this hotel. There was nothing to make the water bubbly.
So it was
all
clear.
It was totally transparent. And he was quite nervous, but then after, you know, he saw that I was very relaxed, then he got relaxed.
Oh, he did. To see that, darling.
And then after that, every other interviewer after that said, we want to interview you in the bathtub.
There's no originality there.
So, I mean, you know, I said, okay, I know. I thought, gee, do I have to do this
Where
over
can you
and
go
over
from
again?
There is the question.
Well, then I went and I bought some bubbles. I said, okay, bring us all the bubbles in. Then my nipples kept sticking up through the phone.
Please.
I know, that's right. It was, they were quite sweet. They looked like prunes.
I never look down. I never look down. I mean, how would you like it if your audiences took all their clothes off?
I would absolutely love it.
I mean, the cloakrooms would be bulging. The dress. Could become the undressed circle. Despite all this, you are a homebody in many
yes,
ways.
Yes, I am.
Do you cook?
Once a year.
What do you cook? Christmas dinner?
I cook I call my mother up and I say, Mom, you have to remind me how to make that Jamaican chicken.
Oh.
And it's spicy and it's got lots of garlic. So if you get heartburn, forget it.
Did you cook for your little boy, your darling little boy?
Oh, yes. He loves my chicken. I mean, that's it. My mom said, Grace, what are you going to do when you get married? This is terrible. You only cook rice and chicken and rice.
She has the most adorable little... Excuse me. Well, that's my kitchen timer. It says Madge is cooked. She's achieved interlock. Yes, I just checked with this... little thermometer here. This is an exciting moment. Madge is going to be unveiled by my in-house surgeon, Professor Dr. Mr. Christian Bernard.